In this video, children,
we will study about electrovalency. What is electrovalency? It is the number of electrons taken
or given by atoms to form ions. You have some idea. Number of electrons given or taken up by the atoms to form ions.
Then we will study what is variable electrovalency.
Children, there are certain elements, various elements, which show more than one electrovalency. Sometimes two, sometimes three, like ferrous, ferric, cuprous, cupric, likewise.
So, this is called variable electrovalency. Now, what is the cause or reason? Causes. Now, one is one stable nature of core or kernel. What is kernel? In simple words, cation. Now, children, take one example of iron. Iron is atomic number 26. 26 means 4s2, 3d6. 26. 26 means 4s2, 3d6.
4s2 means 20 and remaining will go in d. So, accordingly, 26, it is 3d6.
So, 4s2, 3d6. So, it released two electrons of the outer motion, 4s2, and got converted to 3d6. Now, what happens, children? 3d6, you know, is not that stable as it is 3d5. So, what happens? 3d5 is exactly half filled. So, this ferrous has tendency to give out further more electron and readily does it, preferably does it, gives out further more electron and now gets converted to 3d5 and gets converted to ferric. Thus we have iron showing the two states, ferrous and ferric, and we always say that ferric is more stable or more stable because here we have the stable configuration of 3d5. So this was one cause, unstable nature of core or kernel, due to electronic configuration what we have here. Number two is inert electron pair effect. What is this, children? It is the reluctance of NS2 electrons, whichever the outermost shell is there, NS2 electron pair to get excited and to take part in bond formation. Reluctance, not interested, don't prefer, don't want. It is the reluctance of NS2 electron pair to get excited and to take part in the formation of bond. Now, what is this, children? Take example of plumbus, plumbic, plus 2, plus 4, stennis, stennic, plus 2, plus 4. Now, you see here iron, this is 10, sorry. 10 is 50. So, when you write the configuration, it comes as 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, and then 5s2, 5p2. I did not write in the beginning part, I wrote just towards end, the end part, the valence shell. 5s2, 5p2. If you will write, you will get it. Now, children, if it loses all four valence electrons, then it will form SN4 plus ion. And this will have the configuration now of the inner shell because outer motion electrons all lost. 4s2, 4p6 and 4d10. Fine, it's okay. Then we also know it is stennic. It also forms stennis. Why so? How so? Although all four had gone, this was all right, quite stable. Now what happens? Children, in the formation of SN4+, plus, what happened? 5s2 as well as 5p2, all electrons were released. But it was seen. What happened? There's a good energy gap between 5s and 5p. So this involved excitation of 5s electrons to vacant p orbitals. Because 4 means p2 means only 2 were filled out of p3. 1 was still vacant. So, it involves excitation of 5s electrons to 5p orbital. Fine. But then what happens, children? There's large energy gap in 5s and 5p. There was found large energy gap in 5s and 5p. As you go higher and higher, the energy gap also increases between 5s and 5p also. In many cases, it was seen. As you know, chemistry is full of exceptions. So, what happens? Therefore, 5s2 electrons show reluctance to get excited and prefer plus 2. They don't want to go to higher shell. They remain there only. They show reluctance. Hence, instead of all 4 going out, only p2 going out, s2 do not take part in bond formation. They don't get excited and it prefers plus 2. Same in the case of pb plus 4 and plus 2. PB also belongs to group 14. It will also have the configuration like S2 and P2, whichever, like here it is 4, 5s, 5p,
it can be 6s, 6p,
right? So what happened, children? Here too also, configuration is NS2, NP2. Whatever N is there, we are not concerned. This is group 14 elements. So what happens when they all four take part in bond formation? They show plus 4 electrovalency or plus 4 charge. But when only P1s take part in the bond formation, because of the large energy gap between these two, these don't get excited. They don't go to further higher P, right? And they remain reluctant. That's why these elements, especially of group 14, that too, especially lower elements, the big gap, the large gap between the energies of 5s and 5p, they remain, the five, the electrons of s, ns2, whether it is 4s2 or it is 5s2 or it is 6s2, they remain reluctant. They don't want to go to higher shell and they do not take part in bond formation. That's why if I ask you what is the valency of 2 or electrovalency shown by electrovalency shown by lead, you say 2. If I ask for the formula of lead chloride, you will say PbCl2. Because in your mind, you have the valency of lead as 2. Right? But then you also say, it also forms PbCl4. Because, you know, it shows valency plus 4 also. If I ask for the formula of lead oxide, you will say PbO. PbO means valency 2. Electrovalency 2. But then you will say, it also forms PbO2. Because it has electrovalency or charge plus 4 also. If I say septen chloride, quickly you say the answer SnCl2. But if I then you will say gradually, it also forms SnCl4 because that is rarely formed. Because S2 electrons, the valence S2 electrons, NS2 electrons, whichever N is there, 5, 6, whatever, they don't want to go to higher P. P is only 2, so 1 P is vacant. They don't want to get excited because of the large difference of energy, and this is called reluctance of NS2 electron pair to get excited, and overall it is called inert pair effect. That electron pair remains chemically inert, you can say, does not take part in bond formation, and due to that we always say that tin preferably shows plus 2 than plus 4. So Sn and Pd both prefer plus 2 than plus 4 because of inert pair effect. So I hope this is clear, and they may ask you what is inert pair effect or why do elements like Sn10 and Pb, plumbus or lead, preferably show plus 2 than plus 4. It is because of inert pair effect. Give reason if they ask you. Similarly, they ask you why out of ferrous and ferric is more stable. It is this. Or why iron prefers to form Fe3+, then Fe2+, and which out of these more stable? Here it is due to unstable nature of core or candle, which is due to electronic configuration, as it is clear. So we stop here, and I hope this is all for today. You will complete your notes on the regular basis, I'm telling you, children, and keep it ready. Very soon again they will ask you. And today you are sending your work to us latest by 6 p.m. Complete updated work. Children, you are being marked for this. Don't forget. And otherwise also, if you will not update your notes, you will suffer like anything because you will have nothing to study from. Or you have your book, study and see how much you are able to do on your own. It's not that easy, children. We teachers are helping you the best way possible, keeping in mind the time limit. Please follow the instructions. And do good. Thank you, children.